τρεις δε πέντε σαυραμιαί κυρανών παρανών μοντά αυτής και ημάσου τυράξει ιώσον εις Αναστάσεως τη
Παρθένε διαγάρτου εξού σαρκοθέντος ο Άδης ηχμαλώτιστε ο Αδάμανα κεκλείτε η κατάρανε νεκρότε η Εύα ηλευθέρωτε ο θάνατος τε θανάτωτε και η μεν διό ανυμνούντες βόμεν. Ευλογητός Χριστός ο Θεός ημών, ο ούτως ευδοκίσας δόξαζει.
Δόξα σοι τον δείξαντι το φως, δόξα εν υψίστη Θεό και πηγής ειρήνη εν ανθρώπης ευδοκία.
Υμνούμεν σε, ευλογούμεν σε, προσκυνούμεν σε, δοξολογούμεν σε, ευχαριστούμεν σε, δια την μεγάλη σου δόξα.
Κύριε Βασιλεύ, επουράνιε Θεέ, Πάτερ Παντοκράτων, Κύριε Ιε μονογενές Ιησού Χριστέ και Άγιον Πνεύμα.
Κύριε ο Θεός, ο Άνος του Θεού, ο Υιός του Πατρός, ο αίρον την αμαρτίαν του κόσμου, ελέησον ημάς, ο αίρον τας αμαρτίας του κόσμου.
Πρόσεξε την δέησιν ημών, ο καθήμενος εν δεξιά του Πατρός, και ελέησον ημάς.
Μόνος Άγιος, μόνος Κύριος, Ιησούς Χριστός, εις δόξαν Θεού Πατρός, αμήν.
Κάθε καστην ημέραν ευλογήσωσε και εν έσω το όνομά σου εις τον αιώνα και εις τον αιώνα του αιώνος.
Καταξίωσον Κύριε εν τη ημέρα ταύτη αναμαρτήτους φυλαχθήνε ημάς.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε ο Θεός των Πατέρων ημών και ενετών και δε δοξασμένον το όνομά σου εις τους αιώνας αμήν.
Γεννητό Κύριε το έλεος σου εφημάς καθά περιλπίσαμεν επίσε.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξόν με τα δικαιώματά σου.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξόν με τα δικαιώματά σου.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξόν με τα δικαιώματά σου.
Κύριε καταφυγή εγεννήθης ημίν εν γενναία και γενναία εγώ είπα Κύριε ελέησον με ίασε την ψυχή μου ότι μαρτώσει.
Κύριε προσε κατέφυγον διδαξόν με του πειν το θέλημά σου ότι σύ ο Θεός μου.
Ότι παρασύ πηγή ζωής εν το φωτί σου οψόμεθα φως.
Παράτηνον το ελαιός σου της γηνός χουσίσε, Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι.
Και Άγι και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Σωτηρία το κόσμο γέγονεν, άσομεν το Αναστάντη εκ τάφου και αρχηγό της ζωής ημών, κάθε λόγαρ το θάνατο των θάνατων, τον οίκος έδωκεν ημίν και το μέγα ελαιό.
Ευλογημένη Βασιλεία του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Άγιου Πνεύματος νυν και Άγιοι και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Είναι ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεηθωμένη. For the peace from above, for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. Υπέρ της ειρηνής του συμπάντος κόσμος, τα Θεία στον Αγίον του Θεού Εκκλησιών και της των πάντων ενώσεως του Κυρίου δεηθωμένων. For this holy temple, for those who enter with faith, reverence and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. Υπέρ του Αρχιεπισκόπου και Πατρός Σιμών Ιακώβου, του Τιμίου Πρεσβυτερίου της εν Χριστώ Διακονίας, πάντως του κλήρου και του λαού του Κυρίου δεηθωμένων. For the President of our country, for those in civil authority, for the armed forces, for all the American nation, let us pray to the Lord. Υπέρ της Ιεράς Μετροπόλεως καινούριας ταύτης και πάσης πόλεως μονής και χώρας και των πιστικούντων αυτές του Κυρίου δεηθωμένων. For seasonable weather, for the abundance of the fruits of the earth, for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. Υπεπλέοντον οδηπορούντον αεροπορούντον νοσούντον καμνόντον εκμαλώτον και τη σωτηρία αυτών του Κυρίου δεηθωμένων. From all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Αλληλαβούς όσον ελέησον και διαφυλάξον ημάς ο Θεός της συγχαρητή. Αγία Σακράντο, υπερευλογημένης εν δόξου δεσποίησιμον Θεοτόκου και Αϊ Πάρθενου Μαρίας, με πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντες σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών Χριστό το Θεό, παραθούμεθα. Ότι πρέπει εσύ πάσα δόξα, τιμή και προσκύνησης, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Αγίο Πνεύμα, την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Ο Κύριος ευασίλευσεν ευπρέπειαν ενεδίσατο, ενεδίσατο Κύριος, δύναμη και περιεζώσα το.
Τις
λαλίσιτας δυναστείας του Κυρίου, ακουστάς ποιήσεις πάσας,
τα σελέσεις αυτούς.
Υπάτος αν είναι λυτρωμένοι υπό Κυρίου, ους ενελτρώσατο εχειρός εχθρούς.
Εσ πρεσβείες της Θεοτόκου, σώτερ σώσον ημά.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorate our most holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, the Mother of God and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God. Thine is the dominion, thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Εξομολογήσας τα σάντα ελεαυτού και τα θαυμάσια αυτού. Της εις τον ανθρώπο.
Σώσον ημάς, Υιέ Θεού, ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών, ψάλλοντας η Αλληλούια.
Υψωσάτωσαν αυτόν η Εκκλησία Ναού, και με καθέδρο πρεσβυτέρο.
Σώσον ημάς, Υιέ Θεού, ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών, ψάλλοντας η Αλληλούια.
Οι οθαλμοί Κυρίου επί τους ελπίζοντας, επί το έλεος αυτού.
Σώσον ημάς, Υιέ Θεού, ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών, ψάλλοντας η Αλληλούια.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι,
εν ειν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Ο μονογενής Υιός και Λόγος του Θεού, αθάνατος υπάρχον και καταδεξάμενος δια την ημετέραν σωτηρίαν, σαρκωθήνε εκ της Αγίας Θεοτόκου και αη Παρθένου Μαρίας ατρέπτος εν ανθρωπίσας. Σταυρωθήστε Χριστέ ο Θεός θανάτων, θάνατον πατήσας. Ίσον της Αγίας Τριάδος συνδοξαζόμενος το Πατρί και το Άγιο Πνεύματι, σώσον ημάς.
Ετ γέτι εν ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεηθωμέν. Ανηλαβούς όσον ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός τη συγχωρητή. Παναγία Σαλόντου, υπερευλογημένη εν δόξω δεσμίσιμων Θεοτόκου και αη Παρθένου Μαρίας, με τα πάντων τραγίου μνημονεύσαντε σε αυτού και αλλήλου και πάσαν την ζωή ημών. Χριστό το Θεό παραδομέθα. Ότι αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπωμεν. Το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ειν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν. Αυτή η μέρα Κυρίου αγαλιασόμεθα και φρανθούμεν εν αυτή την άχραντον εικόνα σου προσκυνούμεν αγαθέ ετούμεν η συγχώρηση των δεσμάτων ημών. Χριστέ ο Θεός βουλήσει γάρι δόκισαν σαρκίαν ενθύνεν το σταυρό. Η ναρίς Ιησούς έπλασαν εκ της δουλείας του εχθρού. Όθεν ευχαριστός βοόμενση χαρά σε πλήρωσαν τα πάντα ως σωτήριμον. παραγενόμενος εις τον σώσε τον κόσμο.
Σοφία ορθή, δεύτε προσκυνήσομεν και προσπέσομεν Χριστό. Σώσον ημάς, Υιέ Θεό, ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών.
Σαμβολοντάσι, αλληλούια.
Το φεδρόν της Αναστάσεως κήρυγμα εκ του Αγγέλου μαθούσε και του Κυρίου μαθήτριε και την προγονικήν απόφαση να απορρίψασε τες Αποστόλης καυχόμενε έλεγον εσκύλευτε ο θάνατος ηγέρθη Χριστός ο Θεός δωρούμενος το κόσμο το μέγα έλεος.
Όχραν τον εικόνα σου προσκυνούμεν αγαθέ,
ετούμεν η συγχώρηση των θεσμάτων ημών, Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών, βουλή συγκαρυβδόκησας αρκή, ανελθύν εν το σταυρό, ειν αρήσιους έπλασας, εκ της δουλείας του εχθρού, όθεν ευχαρίστος βόμενση, χαράστε πλήρωσας τα πάντα ως σωτήριμον, παραγενόμενος, εις το σώσε τον κόσμο.
Πανεφημον ύμφι Χριστού υμνήσομεν, εκατερίναν την θείαν και πολιούχον σύνα, την βοήθειαν ημών και αντίληψην, ότι εφήμωσε λαμπρός τους κόμψους των ασεβών του πνεύματος τη δύναμη. Ενήνος μάρτης τευτήσαν, ετήτε πάση το μεγαέλεο.
Εν τη γεννήσει την Παρθενία ανεφύλαξας, εν τη κοιμήσει των κόσμων ου κατέλειπες Θεοτόκε, μετέστης προς την ζωήν, μητήρ υπάρχουσα τη ζωής, και τες πρεσβείες τεσές λυτρουμένη εκ θανάτου τα ψυχάς ημών.
No.
Let us pray to the Lord. For though God art holy, unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Σοφία.
Προς Εβραίους επιστολής Παύλου το ανάγνωσμα.
Προσκομέν.
Αδελφοί, πίστη Μωυσής, μέγας γενόμενος, ειρνήσε το λέγεστε Υιός Θυγατρός Φαραώ, μάλλον ελόμενος, συγκακουχίστε το λαό του Θεού,
ή
πρόσφυρον έχειν αμαρτίας απόλαυσιν, μίζων απλούτων, ηγισάμενος των Αιγύπτου θησαυρών, των αντιγισμών του Χριστού. Απέβλεπε γάρ εις την μισθοπολωσίαν, και τι έτη λέγω, επιλείψει γάρ με διηγούμενον ο χρόνος περί Εδεών, Βαράκ τέτοια Σαμσόν και Ιεφτάε, Δαβίδ τέτοια Σαμουήλ και των προφητών, οι διαπίστεως κατηγονήσαν το βασιλείας, εργάσαν το δικαιοσύνην, επέτυχον επαγγελιών, έφραξαν στόματα λεόντων, έσβεσαν δύναμην πυρός,
έφυγαν στόματα μαχαίρας, ενεδυναμώθησαν από ασθενείας, εγεννήθησαν ισχυροί εν πολέμου, παρεμβολάς έκλεινον αλωτρίων, έλαβαν γυναίκες εξαναστάσεως τους νεκρούς αυτών, άλλοι δε εν την πανίστησαν, ου προσεξάμενοι την απολύτρωσιν, ή ακρίτενος αναστάσεως τείχωσιν. Έτεροι δε εμπεγμών και μαστίγων πήραν έλαβον, έτη δε δεσμών και φυλακής. Ελιθάστησαν, επρίστησαν, επειράστησαν, εν φόνο μαχαίρας απέθανον, περιήλθον εμιλωτές εν αγίης δέρμασιν, ιστερούμενοι, θλιβόμενοι, κακοχούμενοι, ονούκιν άξιος ο κόσμος, εν ερημίες πλανόμενοι και όρεση, και σπηλαίης και τεσοπές της γης. Και ούτι πάντες μαρτυρηθέντες δια της πίστεως, ούκ εκομίσαντο την επαγγελίαν του Θεού περί ημών κριτών τι προβλεψαμένου. Ηλα μη χωρίσιμον τελειωθώσει.
Let us attend.
Blessed are you, O Lord, God of our fathers, for you are righteous in all things you have done for us.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Hebrews.
Let us attend.
Brethren, by faith Moses, when he was grown up, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to share ill treatment with the people of God than to enjoy the fleeting pleasures of sin. And what more shall I say? For time would fail me to tell of Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah, of David and Samuel and the prophets, who through faith conquered kingdoms, enforced justice, received promises, stopped the mouths of lions, quenched raging fire, escaped the edge of sword, won strength out of weakness, became mighty in war, put foreign armies to flight. Women received their dead by resurrection. Some were tortured, refusing to accept release, that they might rise again to a better life. Others suffered mocking and scourging, and even chains and imprisonment. They were stoned. They were sawn in two. They were killed with the sword. They went about in skins of sheep and goats, destitute, afflicted, ill-treated, of whom the world was not worthy, wandering over deserts and mountains and in dens and caves of the earth. And in all these, though well attested by their faith, did not receive what was promised, since God had foreseen something better for us, that apart from us they should not be made perfect.
Peace be with you, the reader. Ακούσμεν του Αγίου Ευαγγελίου, ειρήνη πόση. Εκ του κατά Ιωάννην Αγίου Ευαγγελίου του ανάγνωσμα, Κύριο εκείνο, η θέληση ο Ιησούς εξελθήν εις την Γαλιλαίαν και βρίσκει Φίλιππον και λέγει αυτό, ακολούθη μη. Ειν δε ο Φίλιππος από Βυσθαϊδά εκ της πόλεως Ανδρέου και Πέτρου, ευρίσκει Φίλιππος τον Αθαναήλ και λέγει αυτό, «Ον έγραψε Μωυσής, εν το νόμο και οι προφήτε, ευρήκαμεν Ιησούν τον γιον του Ιωσήφ, τον από Ναζαρέτ. Και είπεν αυτόν Αθαναήλ, εκ Ναζαρέτ δυνατέ τι αγαθόν είναι, λέγει αυτό Φίλιππος, έρχου και είδε. Είδεν ο Ιησούς τον Αθαναήλ ερχόμενον προς αυτόν και λέγει περί αυτού, είδε αληθώς Ισραηλίτης, εν ο δόλος ουκέστη. Λέγει αυτόν Αθαναήλ, πόθεν με γινώσκεις. Απικρίθη Ιησούς και είπεν αυτό, πρώτου σε Φίλιππον φανίσε, όντα υπό την σικήν είδον σε. Απικρίθη Ναθαναήλ και λέγει αυτό, Ραβή, σύ ο Υιός του Θεού, σύ βασιλεύς του Ισραήλ. Απικρίθη Ιησούς και είπεν αυτό, ότι είπον σύ είδον σε υποκάτω της σικής πιστεύεις, μίζω τούτον όψι. Και λέγει αυτό, αμήν αμήν λέγω ημίν, απάρτι όψεστε των ουρανών αιώγωτα. Και τους αγγέλους του Θεού αναβαίνοντας και κατεβαίνοντας επί των υιών του ανθρώπου, reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. John. Let us be attentive. At that time, Jesus decided to go to Galilee, and he found Philip and said to him, follow me. Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, we have found him of whom Moses and the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph. Nathanael said to him, can anything good possibly come out of Nazareth? And Philip said to him, come and see. Jesus saw Nathanael coming to him and said of him, behold, an Israelite indeed in whom there is no guile. Nathanael said to him, how do you know me? Jesus answered him, before Philip even called you, when you were under the fig tree, I saw you. Nathanael answered him, Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel. Jesus answered him, because I simply said to you, I saw you under the fig tree, do you believe? For I tell you, you shall see even greater things than these. And he said to him, truly, truly, I say to you, you will see heaven open, and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man.
Δόξα σοι, Κύριε, δόξα.
That being ever protected by thy power to thee, we may ascribe glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
No one who is bound with the desires and pleasures of flesh. He is worthy to approach or draw near or to serve thee, O King of glory. For to serve thee is great and awesome, even to the heavenly powers, yet through thine ineffable and boundless love toward mankind. Thou didst unchangeably and immutably become man and served as your high priest, and as Lord of all, is committed to us the celebration of liturgical and bloodless sacrifice. Thou alone, our Lord, our God, rulest over all things in heaven and earth, who art born on the throne of the cherubim, and our Lord of the seraphim, King of Israel, who alone art holy, rests among thy saints. Wherefore implore thee, who alone art good and ready to listen, look down upon me, thy sinful and unprofitable servant. And cleanse my soul and my heart from an evil conscience, and enable me by the power of the Holy Spirit, vessel of the recent of the priesthood, to stand before this thy holy altar and consecrate thy holy and immaculate body and precious blood. For to thee I come, having bowed my head and beseech thee, turn not thy face away from me, neither check me among thy children. But make me worthy, thy sinful and unworthy servant, to offer these gifts unto thee. For thou art the offer, the accept, distributed, O Christ our God, and to ascribe glory, together, eternal Father, and thine, O holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Τα χειροβήμα τη υποσχέση μα από το ημερήμαν. Ω το δασελεύ, τον όρο του δοξόμενου τη Αγγλία. Διεφορούμε τα ξελουλούια, αλληλούια, αλληλούια. όντων ημών και πάντων των ευσεβών και ορθοδόξων χριστιανών. Μνηστεί Κύριος ο Θεός εν τη βασιλεία αυτού πάντοτε νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Την δέησιν ημών το Κύριο.
Κύριε ελέησον.
For these precious gifts here presented, let us pray to the Lord.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Αντιλαβούς όσον ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός, τη συγχάρητη.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Την ημέραν πάσαν τέλειαν Αγίαν ειρήκην και ραμάρτητον, παρά του Κυρίου ετισόμεθα.
Πάσχου
For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Ask,
O Kyrie. For things that are good and profitable unto our souls. And for peace in the world, let us ask of the Lord. Τον υπόλοιπον χρόνον της ζωής ημών, εν ειρήνη και μετανοία εκτελέσε, παρά του Κυρίου ετισόμεθα. The end of our lives may be Christian, without pain, blameless, and peaceful. And for good account at the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Αγία Σακράντου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξω δεσποίησιμον Θεοτόκου και ο υπόρθενου Μαρίας με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσετε σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών Χριστό το Θεό παραθωμεθώ. Διά των νυκτυρμών του Μαριανού σου Υιού μεθου ευλογητός εσύ το Παναγίο και αγαθό και ζωπιό σου πνεύματι, νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Peace be with you. Love one another.
that with one mind we may confess. Τεστίδας, εν σοφία προσκομέν.
Πιστεύω εις ένα Θεόν, Πατέρα Παντοκράτορα, ποιητήν ουρανού και γης, ορατών δε πάντων και οράτων, και εις ένα Κύριον Ιησούν Χριστόν, τον Υιόν του Θεού τον μονογενή, τον εκ του Πατρός γεννηθέντα προπάντων των αιώνων. Πως εκποτός Θεών αληθινών εκ Θεού αληθινού, γεννηθέντα ου ποιηθέντα, ομοούσιον το Πατρί, διού τα πάντα ηγένετο. Τον δι' ημάς τους ανθρώπους, και δια την ημετέραν σωτηρίαν, κατελθόντα εκ των ουρανών, και σαρκωθέντα εκ πνεύματος Αγίου και Μαρίας Παρθένου και ανθυπήσαντα. Σταυρωθέντα το υπερημών, επί Ποντίου Πιλάτου, και παθόντα και τα φέντα, και αναστάντα τη τρίτη ημέρα κατά τας γραφάς, και ανελθόντα εις τους ουρανούς, και κατεζόμενον εκ δεξιών του Πατρός, και πάλι ενερχόμενον τα δόξης, κρίνεζόντας και νεκρούς, ούτε της βασιλείας, ούτε στο τέλος, και εις το πνεύμα το Άγιον, το Κύριον, το Ζωοποιόν, το εκ του Πατρός εκπαρεμόμενον, το συμπατρί και Υιό συμπροσκυνούμενον, και συνδοξαζόμενο το λαλήσαν διά των προφητών. Ισμίαν, Αγίαν, Καθολικήν και Αποστολικήν Εκκλησία, ομολογώ εν βάπτισμα εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών, προσδοκώ Ανάσταση νεκρών και ζωή του μέλλοντος αιώνος. Αμήν.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come.
Amen. Στομεν καλό, στομεν με το φόβο, προσκομεν την Αγία να φοράν εν ειρήνη προσφέρει. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you
all.
Let us lift up our hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord.
τον επινίκιον ύμνον άδοντα, βούντα και κραγότα και λέγοντα.
Αγίος, Αγίος, Αγίος Κύριος Σαββαώθ, πλήρης ο ουρανός και η γη της δόξης.
These blessed powers, Master, and the love of mankind, be sinners proud, and truly are the holy. But once you disobey you, the true God, born in the likeness of our own body, and having lived in this world, and having given precepts for salvation, turn away from us idolatry. Rising on the third day, he prepared the way for the resurrection of the flesh and the dead, because it is not possible for him, the author of life, to be held by it. He thus became the first fruits of those who had fallen asleep, the firstborn from the dead, that in everything he might be preeminent. Ascending into heaven, he was enthroned at the right hand, your majesty on high, whence he shall come to render to each of us according to his deeds. But he left us in remembrances of his passion. On the night that he gave himself up for the world, taking bread in his holy and spotless hands, and presenting it to you, God the Father, he gave thanks, blessed and sanctified and broke it, and then he said,
Εδώ και της Αγίης αυτού μαθητές και Αποστόλης είπων, λάβετε, φάγετε, τούτο μαέστη το σώμα του επέριμον κλώμενον εις άφησιν αμαρτιών. He gave to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you from the remission of sins.
And likewise, taking the cup of the fruit, he and the vine, mixing it, giving thanks, blessing and sanctifying it.
Εδώ και της Αγίης αυτού μαθητές και Αποστόλης είπων, πίνετε εξ αυτού πάντες, τούτο εστί το αίμα μου το της Καινής Διαθήκης, το επερημών και πολλών ευκοινόμενων εις άφεσιν αμάρτιον. He gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Drink of this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins.
Do this in remembrance of me, for whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim my death and confess my resurrection. Therefore, Master, we are to remember his saving sufferings, the life-giving cross, the 3 days in the tomb, the resurrection from the dead, the ascension into heaven, the enthronement at your right hand, God the Father, and his glorious and awesome second coming.
The sanctum sanctum si prosferomen κατά πάντα και δια πάντα.
Thus it is, most holy Master, that we too, those sinners, and your unworthy servants and ministers, yet judged worthy to serve at your sacred altar, not for any righteousness of ours, for we have done nothing good on earth, but by virtue of your love and mercy richly lavished on us, make bold to approach your holy sacrificial table, and setting out the antitypes of your holy body and precious blood in your cup, your Christ, we ask and entreat you in your goodness that your Holy Spirit may come down upon us and upon these gifts here presented to bless them, sanctify them, and make them manifest.
this bread as the precious body of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, and this cup, the precious blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, which was shed for the life and redemption of the world. Amen. 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 And for all of us partaking of the one bread and cup, unite us to one another in the communion of the Holy Spirit, and let none of us partake for judgment or condemnation of the sacred body and blood of your Christ, but rather that we may know mercy and grace together with all the saints and through the ages, having pleased you well. Forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, teachers, and every righteous soul who has been perfected through faith.
Εξαιρετός της Παναγίας Σακράντου υπερευλοημένης εν δόξω δεσμίσιμον Θεοτόκου και αη Παρθένου Μαρίας.
Επίσης χαίρι και χαριτωμένη πάσα εκτίζεις αγγέλων το σύστημα και ανθρώπων το γένος, υγειασμένε ναε και παράδεισε λόγικε, παρθενικών καύχημα, εξής Θεός εσαρκώθη,
for St. John the prophet, forerunner and baptist, the holy, glorious, and all illustrious apostles, for the saints whose memory we honor today, be mindful of all who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection of eternal life. Further, we pray, be mindful, Lord, of your holy Catholic and apostolic church, from one end of the earth to the other, and keep her in peace. You have made her yours through the precious blood of your Christ, and have made this holy house firm to the end of time. Be mindful, Lord, of those who have offered you these gifts, as well as those for whom, through whom, and in behalf of whom have offered them. Remember, Lord, who bring forth fruit and do good works in your holy churches and are concerned for the poor. Reward them with your rich heavenly blessings in place of worldly gifts. Grant them, heavenly ones, in place of transitory gifts, eternal blessings. Instead of the passing, the lasting. Remember, Lord, those who live in deserts and mountains and dens and caves of the earth. Keep in mind, Lord, those who persevere in virginity, ascetics, and those who live seemly lives. Remember, Lord, those in authority over us, whom their piety and faith and you have judged worthy to rule on earth. Let truth be their armor, your favor their crown. In time of war, watch over them, strengthen their rule, subject them to the alien and warmongering peoples. Grant them deep and enduring peace. Seek good to their hearts for the sake of your church and all your people, and in their tranquility, we ourselves may live serene and quiet lives in all piety and dignity. Remember, Lord, all the officials and authorities and our brethren in government and the service of this country. Persevere, be, and the good in their goodness. Make the wicked good through their goodness. Be mindful, O Lord, of the people assembled here, as well as those who are absent for good cause. Show mercy to them and to us in your abundant mercy. Fill their households with every good thing. Sustain their marriages in peace and harmony. Nurture the infants, train up the youth, support the elderly, comfort the faint-hearted. Gather in those that are scattered and lead them back to who have strayed, uniting them to your holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. Liberate those that are troubled by your unclean spirits. Sail with those at sea. Accompany the wayfarers. Plead for the widow and shield the orphans. Free the captives and heal the afflicted. O God, look after those who are on trial or condemned to the mines or to exile or bitter slavery, or in any way hard-pressed in want, extremity, all who stand in need of your boundless compassion, those who love us as well as those who hate us, those who have empowered us, unworthy though we are, to pray in their behalf. Be mindful, O Lord, our God, of all the people who lavish on your rich mercy, granting to all which leads to salvation. And if we have failed to commemorate anyone, whether through out of ignorance or forgetfulness, or because of the great number of names you, O God, will remember, for you know each one's age and name, since you have known each of us from our mother's womb. For you, O Lord, are the help of the helpless, the hope of the hopeless, rescuer of the tempest tossed, safe haven for sailors, healer of the sick. Be mindful of all people, for you know each of us and what we would ask, our homes, our needs. Defend this city, O Lord, this community, and every city and land against famine and pestilence, earthquake and flood, against fire and the sword, against alien attack and all civil strife.
Εν πρώτης μίστητη Κύριε του Αρχιεπισκόπου και Πατρός ημών Ιακώβου, ον χάρισε της Αγίας Εκκλησίας εν ειρήνη σών εν ημονιά με κοβερεύοντα και ορθού το μόντο των λόγων σου, της εις αληθείας και ον έκαστος κατ' διάνοιαν έχει και πάντων και πασών.
Δεύτε ορθοδόξον εστρατείε, τα σεπτάς εικόνας του σωτήρος ημών Χριστού και της Θεοτόκου και πάντων των Αγίων, ευσεύω φρόνος πάντες κατασπασόμεθα.
And grant that with one mouth and one heart we may glorify and praise thine all honorable and majestic name, of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
And the mercies of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, shall be with you all. Having commemorated all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For these precious gifts which have been offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord. That our merciful God, who hath received them on his holy and celestial and invisible altar unto a scent of spiritual fragrance, may send down upon us divine grace, the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray.
Kyrie eleison.
Την ενότητα της πίστεως και την κοινωνία του Αγίου Πνεύματος ετισάμενη αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών, Χριστό το Θεό παραθούμεθα. Και καταξίωσον ημάς δέσποτε με την παρησία σα κατακρίτως τόλμαν επικαλείστε σε τον επουράνιον Θεόν Πατέρα και λέγει Πάτερ ημών, ο εν της ουρανής, αγιαστήτω το όνομά σου, ελθέτω η βασιλεία σου, γεννηθήτω το θέλημά σου, ως εν ουρανό και επί της γης, τον άρτον ημών των επιούσιων, δώσ' ημίν σήμερα, και άφεσι ημίν τα αφιλήματα ημών, ως και εμείς αφήμεν σε φιλέτης ημών, και εμείς εν έγκυσι μας πειρασμών, αλλά ρίσαι εμάς από το πονηρού. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Ειρήνη πάση. Τα σκεφαλά σημών το Κύριο κλείνομαι.
Κύριε.
Χαρή
πολιτική εκτιμή και φιλανθρωπία του μονογενού σου ή μεθού ευλογητό ει σύντο Παναγίου και αγαθό και ζωπιό σου πνεύμα την ίνκια ή και στου αιώνα των αιώνων. Μιλήσετε και ενημερίζετε ο μνός του διμελιζόμενος και μη διρούμενος, ο πάντοτε θεόμενος και μη δε ποτέ δε πανόμενος τους διόντος αγιάζουν. Κύριο Πατρίου πίστεως Πνεύματος Αγίου, ευλογημένη ζέσου να είσαι Κύριε πάντοτε νίκη αγίου και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν ζέσεις πίστης πλήρης Πνεύματος Αγίου. Which came to come into the world to save sinners. Also, we believe that this is thy sacred body and this is thy precious blood. Therefore, we pray to thee, have mercy on us and pardon our transgression, voluntary and involuntary, in word and in deed, both known and unknown, and make us worthy to partake of thy sacred mystery and unto life everlasting. Amen. Σου τσιμιστικό σήμερα του Θεού και νου παράλαβε ου μηγά της εχθρής σου των μυστήριων υπό ου φίλοι μας εδώ σε κάθε περιούδας αλλός ο μυστής ομόν και σημείς του Κύριε και Βασιλιά σου ο Θεός ελάστη μη τον Παρθολόν και λεισόμεν ο Θεός ελάστη μη τον Παρθολόν και λεισόμεν ο Θεός ελάστη μη τον Παρθολόν. Έτσι μεταδίδωτε με τη Μαθαίο τον αξίο γερμανάχο τον τιμή και πανάγιο. Σώμα εις άψη μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον ανήν. Έτσι μεταδίδωτε με τη Μαθαίο τον αξίο γερμανάχο τον τιμή και πανάγιο. Αίμα εις άψη μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Εις το όνομα του Πατρός. Αμήν και του Υιού. Αμήν και του Αγίου Πνεύματος.
Πιστεύω, Κύριε, και ομολογώ ότι εσύ αληθώς ο Χριστός, ο Υιός του Θεού του Ζώντος, ο ελθόνης του κόσμου να αμαρτωλού σώσε, ον πρώτος είμαι εγώ. Έτι πιστεύω ότι τούτο αυτό εστί το άχρον τον σώμα σου και τούτο αυτό εστί το τίμιον αίμα σου. Δέομαι ουν σου. Ελέησόμε και συγχωρησόμε τα παραπτώματά μου, τα εκούσια και τα ακούσια, τα εν λόγω, τα εν έργο, τα εν γνώση και αγνία. Και αξίωσόμε ακατακρίτως με τα σχήν των αχράνων σου μυστηρίων, εις άφεση αμαρτιών και εις ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. I believe, O Lord, and I confess that Thou art verily the Christ, the Son of the living God, who didst come into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. Also I believe that this is thy sacred body, and this thy precious blood. Therefore I pray to thee, have mercy on me and pardon my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and deed, both known and unknown, and make me worthy to partake of thy sacred mysteries, unto the remission of sins, and unto life eternal. Amen. Behold, I approach for Holy Communion. O Creator, burn me not as I partake. For Thou art fire which burns the unworthy. Wherefore do Thou cleanse me from every stain. Receive me today, O Son of God, as a partaker of Thy mystical feast. For I will not speak of the mystery to Thine enemies. I will not kiss Thee as did Judas, but as the thief I will confess Thee. Lord, remember me when Thou comest in Thy kingdom.
Με το φόβο Θεού πίστεως και αγάπης προσέρθετε. Μεταλαμβάνει η δόλη του Θεού, εκατερίνει εις άφησης μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. The servant of God, Constantinos, is communed for the remission of his sins and for life everlasting. Μεταλαμβάνει η δόλη του Θεού, εκατερίνει εις άφησης μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Μεταλαμβάνει η δόλη του Θεού, Constantinos, is άφησης μαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. The servant of God, the sins of her life everlasting. Divine you, the Lord of the Lord, the Savis Martion, Kezuin, Union, Amin, the servant of God, the Lord is communed for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Vasiliki is communed for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. The servant of God, Sophia, for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting, the servant of God, Mariana, is communed for the remission of her sins and for life everlasting. Divine Yudhulu, Ekaterini, Savis Martion, Kezuin, Eunion, Amin. Metalavani, Idhuli, Tutheu, Yodia, Savis Martion, Kezuin, Eunion, Amin. Servant of God, is communed for the remission of our sins, for life everlasting. Servant of God, Ioannis, is communed for the remission of his sins, for life everlasting. Servant of God, is communed for the remission of our sins, for life everlasting. Servant of God, is communed for the remission of his sins, for life everlasting. Martion, Jesuit, Union, Amin. Servant of God, the mission of the sins of life everlasting. Is there any duty to do? Fortini, Savis Martion, Jesuit, Union, Amin. Let the man you do lust to do. Savis Martion, Jesuit, Union, Amin. Everlasting. Commune for the remission of our sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God, Lucas is commune for the remission of sins and for life everlasting. Σώσον ο Θεός του λαού σου και ευλογήσον την κληρονομίαν σου.
Είδομεν το φως το αληθινό, και ελάβομεν πνεύμα εκ ουράνιον, εύρομεν πιστην αλήθη, αδιέρετον τριάδα προσκυνούντες. Αυτή γάρη μας εσώσε.
Πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Let us rise, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, immortal, heavenly, life-giving and awesome mysteries of Christ. Worthily let us give thanks unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Having asked the Lord that this whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our Lord. Ότι εσύ ο Ιεσμός ημών και εσύ την δόξαν αναπέμπομεν, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύματι νυν και Άγιοι, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Εν ειρήνη προέλθομεν του Κυρίου δεηθόμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Πάτερ Άγιε ευλόγησον.
O Lord, who blesses those and bless thee and sanctify those who put their trust in thee, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Protect the whole body of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy temple. Do thou glorify them with the divine power and forsake not us who set our hope in thee. Grant peace to the world, to the churches, to the priests, to the civil authorities, to the armed forces, and to all thy people. For all good giving and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from thee, the Father of lights. And to thee we ascribe glory and thanksgiving and worship to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Όνομα Κυρίου ευλογημένον από του νυν και ως του αιώνων.
Το όνομα Κυρίου ευλογημένον από του νυν και ως του αιώνων.
Το όνομα Κυρίου ευλογημένον από τον ήν και ως του
να είναι ευλογημένο.
Προσκυνούμεν αγαθέ ετού.
μένει συγχωρήσιν των δεσμάτων ημών Χριστέ ο Θεό. Βουλήσει γάρι βδόκισας σαρκή ανελθήν εν το σταυρό. Εκ της δουλείας του εχθρού όθεν ευχαρίστως βοόμενσι χαρά σε πλήρωσα στα πάντα ο σωτήριμον παραγενόμενος εις το σώσε τον κόσμο.
Ελέησον ημάς ο Θεός κατά το μέγα ελέος σου, δεόμεθά σου επάκουσον και ελέησον.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Έτι δεόμεθα υπέρ των ευσεβών και ορθοδόξων χριστιανών.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Έτι δεόμεθα υπέρ όλων των ορθοδόξων ιεραρχών πάντως του κλήρου και του λαού και πάσης της εν Χριστώ ημών αδελφότητος.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Έτι δεόμεθα υπέρ ελέου ζωής ειρήνης υγείας σωτηρίας επισκέψεως συγχωρήσεως και αφέσεως των αμαρτιών των δούλων του Θεού, πάντων των ευσεβών και ορθοδόξων χριστιανών, των κατοικούντων και βρισκομένων εν τη πόλη και κοινότητη ταύτη, των ενωρητών, επιτρόπων, συνδρομητών, αβηρετών, ενεκαινιστών, του Αγίου Ναού τούτο, κοπιόντων, ψαλόντων, διδασκόντων και διδασκομένων, εν του Αγίου τούτο, καθιδρύματι μετά των σύζυγων, τέκνων και γονέων, αδελφών, συγγενών αυτών, και υπές γιουριθήν αυτής παμπλημέλε εκούσιονται και ακούσιον.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Ότι ελέημον και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις και εσύ την δόξαν εναπέμπωμεν. Το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν. Την άχραντον εικόνα σου προσκυνούμεν αγαθέ, ετούμεν εις συγχώρηση των δεσμάτων ημών Χριστέ ο Θεός. Βουλήσει γάρι βδόκισας σαρκή ανελθήν εν το σταυρό. Χρήση σου σε πλάσας εκ της δουλείας του εχθρού.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
Again we pray for the blessed memory, the eternal rest of the souls of your departed servants, the kings, patriarchs, bishops, priests, the higher monks, deacons, monks, nuns, and all the departed pious Orthodox Christians from one end of the earth to the other, our fathers, forefathers, grandparents, great-grandparents, parents, brothers, sisters, spouses, and relatives, and for the forgiveness of all their errors, both voluntary and involuntary.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie. Aeonia in me,
the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your departed servants, all the pious and orthodox Christians, O Christ our God. And to you we ascribe glory, together with the beginningless Father and your holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Την άχραντον εικόνα σου προσκυνούμεν αγαθέ, ετούμεν συγχώρησιν των δεσμάτων ημών. Χριστέ ο Θεός, φούλης ηγάρη βδόκησες ανενθύνεν το σταυρό, ειν αρίσεις ους επλάσας εκ της δουλείας του εχθρού.
Ελέησον ημάς ο Θεός κατά το μεγαλέο σου, δεόμεθά σου επάκουσον και ελέησον.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Έτι δέμεθα υπέρ των ευσεβών και ορθοδόξων Χριστιανών.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Έτι δέμεθα υπέρ όλων των ορθοδόξων ιεραρχών, παντός του κλήρου και του λαού και πάσης της εν Χριστώ ημών αδελφότητος.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Ότι ελέημον και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις και εσύ την δόξαν εν απέμπωμεν, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν. Την άχραντον εικόνα σου προσκυνούμεν αγαθέ, ετούμεν εις συγχώρηση των δεσμάτων ημών. Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών, βουλής ηγάρ ευδόκησας ανεν ίεν τόνς, ειν αρίσεις ους επλάσας εκ της δουλείας του εχθρού. Όθεν ευχαριστός βοόμενσι χαράς επλήρωσας τα πάντα ως σωτήριμον, παραγενόμενος εις τον σώσε τον κόσμο.
Ελέησον ημάς ο Θεός κατά το μεγαλέο σου, δέομεθά σου επάκουσον και ελέησον.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Έτι δέομεθα υπέρ των ευσεβών και ορθοδόξων Χριστιανών.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Έτι δέμεθα υπέρ του διαφυλακθήνε την Αγίαν Εκκλησίαν και την πόλην και την κοινότητα ταύτην, και πάσαν πόλην και χώραν από λοιμού, λοιμού, σεισμού, καταποντισμού, πυρός μαχαίρας, επιδρομής αλλοφύλων και εμφωνίου πολέμου, και υπέρ των ήλιων ευμενή και διάλακτων γενέστε, των αγαθών και φιλάνθρωπων Θεών ημών, το αποστρέψε και διασκεδάσε πάσαν οργήν και νόσων, την καθημόν κοινωμένη, και ρίσασα ημάς εκ της δικαίας αυτού απελής, και λαΐσα ημάς.
Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον.
Hear us, O God, our Savior, the hope of all the ends of the earth, and of those who sail in on the distant seas and traverse the air. Be gracious and show mercy, O Master, upon our sins. Be merciful to us.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
ότι ελέημον και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις και εσύ την δόξαν εν απέμπομεν, το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίν και Άγιοι, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Του Κυρίου δεηθόμεν.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Οι προφήτες ως είδων, οι Απόστολοι ως δίδαξαν, η Εκκλησία ως παρέλαβεν, οι διδάσκαλοι ως εδογμάτισεν, οι οικουμένοι ως συμπεριφώνηκεν, η χάρις ως έλαβεν, η αλήθεια όπως αποδέκτηκτε, το ψεύδος ως απελήλυτε, η σοφία ως επερησιάσατο, ο Χριστός ως ευράβευσεν, ούτω φρονούμεν, ούτω λαλούμεν, ούτω κηρύσσομεν Χριστόν των αληθινών Θεών ημών, και τους αυτού Αγίους εν λόγεις, τιμώντες εν συγγραφές και νοήμασιν, εν θυσίες, εν ναείς, εν εικονίσμασι, ομέν ως Θεόν και Δεσπότην, προσκαινούντες και σέβοντες, τους δε διά των κοινών Δεσπότην, ως αυτού γνησίους θεράποντες, τιμώντες την τίν, κατά σχέσιν προσκύνησιν, αμέπτοντες αυτή η πίστη των Αποστόλων, αυτή η πίστη των Πατέρων, αυτή η πίστη των Ορθοδόξων, αυτή η πίστη την οικουμένη εστήριξεν, επί τούτης τους της ευσεβίας κήρυκες αδελφικός, τε και εις δόξαν τιμήν της ευσεβίας υπέρ και γονίσαντο ανεφημούμεν και λέγουμεν. As the prophets beheld, as the apostles have taught, as the teachers have dogmatized, as the universe has agreed, as grace has shone forth, as truth was revealed, as falsehood has been dissolved, as wisdom has presented, as Christ awarded, thus we declare, thus we assert, thus we preach Christ our true God, and honor his saints in words, in writings, in thoughts, in sacrifices, in churches, in these the holy icons, and on the one hand worshiping and reverencing Christ as God and Lord, and on the other honoring them as true servants of the same Lord of all, and offering them the proper veneration. This is the faith of the apostles. This is the faith of the fathers. This is the faith of the Orthodox. This is the faith which has established the universe. Furthermore, to these messengers of piety, with brotherly and fatherly love and reverence in glory and honor of piety for which they fought, we praise and cry out. Today we declare, entreating God that we instructed and strengthened by their exploits and struggles and teachings and piety, which are godly unto life unto the end, may we prove worthy of all these requests by the compassion and grace of Christ, the great and first archpriest, and our true God through the intercessions of our most glorious Lady Theotokos and Ever Virgin Mary, the God-like angels, and all the saints. Amen. Tis Theos Megasos.
Εν της λαής την δύναμή σου.
Εις Θεός μεγάσος ο πανινήρξαμην αυτή η αλλίωση δεξιάς του υψίστου.
Της Θεός Μέγασος, ο Θεός
of the Lord, for I will remember your wonders from the beginning. Κύριο και έλεος αυτού εθυμάστη αυτού Θεία χάρητη και φιλανθρωπία πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Δόξα σοι ο Θεός ελπίσιμον, Κύριε, δόξα σοι.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Κύριε ελέησον, Πάτερ Άγιε ευλόγησον.
Ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών Χριστός ο νυθρινός Θεός ημών, τες πρεσβείας της Παναχράντου και Παναμόμου Αγίας αυτού Μητρός, δυνάμει του Τιμίου και Ζωπίου Σταυρού, προστασίας του Τιμίου Πρανίου Δυνάμινου Σωμάτων, ηγεσίας του Τιμίου Ενδόξου Προφήτου Προδρόμου και Βαπτιστού Ιωάννου, των Αγίων Ενδόξων και Πανεφήμων Αποστόλων, των Αγίων Ενδόξων και Καλλινίκων Μαρτύρων, των Οσίων και Θεοφόρων Πατέρων ημών, τον Αγίης Πατρός ημών Βασιλείου Αρχιεπισκόπου Κεσαρίας Ουρανοφάντορος του Μεγάλου, τον Αγίων και Δικαίων Θεοπατώρων Ιωακήμ και Άνιης, τον Αγίων Σεβαστία Τεσσεράκοντα Μαρτύρων και πάντων των Αγίων, ελεήσε και σώσε εμάς, ως αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος και ελέημον Θεός.
Εμάς, Κύριε, φύλατε, εις πολλά έτη.
Διευχών των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον ημάς. Η Αγία Τριάστε φυλάξε πάντες ημάς, καλημέρα σας και χρόνια σας πολλά.
Thank you.
προσέχου σαν το κράτος απρός μαχητών.
Εκ παντέων με κινδύνων ελευθερώσον.
Ειν ακράζωση χαίρε νύμφια, νύμφε εύτε.
Feast day this morning of the holy icons, the restoration of the holy icons into the churches. In your bulletin, it mentions the upcoming Vesper service this evening at St. John's Church in Despains, where there will be the Vespers for the restoration of the icons. For the Sunday of Orthodoxy, it is a inter-Orthodox service of all of the other jurisdictions, of which will join the Greek Orthodox jurisdiction, with the Vesper service and, of course, the statement of faith upon the restoration of the icons in the 9th century back into the churches. Tomorrow evening, as we are entering the second week of Lent, we will celebrate the Great Compline service at 6 o'clock, and immediately following, we will have our adult Bible study in St. Catherine's. On Wednesday morning, again in St. Catherine's, there will be the service of pre-sanctified liturgy
And on Friday at 7 o'clock will be the second installment of the salutations, the Caritas Me service, the salutations to the Virgin Mary. Please also be aware that on Saturday is our youth retreat beginning about 9 o'clock. And that is for the youth of the parish. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Each year, our Orthodox churches throughout the world, as you just witnessed, celebrate the first Sunday of Great Lent, marked with the procession of the icons, the same service was performed downstairs for our children in their Sunday School Divine Liturgy. Because the two services coincide with each other, sometimes we're able to bring the children up, other times we're not. So we did not have the children come up this year because at the moment we were doing our service, they were doing the same exact service downstairs. But the service is one of great significance in commemorating that glorious day on March 11th, 843 AD, when the icons were restored back into the Orthodox churches, into the Christian churches. And if we look around us at our magnificent church today, imagine what this and all of the churches would look without icons. Does the word Protestant come to mind? Iconography is built and woven into the fabric of Orthodoxy. It defines our Orthodox faith. We also look upon this first Sunday of Great Lent as an opportunity to continue the process which we have begun with our Lenten journey to give, hopefully, serious responsibility for our life and our souls during the season of preparation. We said last week as we were on the doorstep of our Great Lent that Great Lent is a time to take stock on how our lives are going, how we shape up to our faith. It is a time when we are asked to make choices. It is the time and the season when we need to review and to reassess our lives and put them hopefully in proper direction and in order in preparing for the glorious resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This great Lenten season that we experience each year can best be described as us being at a point or a crossroads of either choosing Christ or abandoning Him. Those of us that have been followers of Christ for most of our lives can look back at significant moments in our lives when we were called upon to make choices, to either choose Christ's way or our own way. Maybe the decision involved our choice of marriage partners, our choice of jobs, our choice of priorities, what we place importance, a choice of giving in to or resisting temptation. These are all choices And if we can't recall any such crossroad moments in our lives, perhaps we need to examine whether we view our faith as important at all, and whether our faith has had or really has any impact on our daily lives. If we seem to be comfortable and we are perfectly content with the status quo, then something is wrong. Something is amiss, because our faith should make us feel uncomfortable in some aspect of our behavior and how we conduct ourselves in this less than Christian society that we live in. And that's the beauty of Great Lent, because it hits us square in the forehead if we truly understand it. It's a call to wake up. The Lenten season in our Orthodox way is a perfect time to confront this question of choice, because this is the season in which we are called upon to understand and to remember Jesus' sacrifice for us. It's a time to realign our lives with a Savior who made the ultimate choice, the choice to lay down His life on our behalf. So if we take our faith seriously, then it's not too much to ask that we be willing to make some tough choices for our own faith and our own soul. Throughout Jesus' life here on earth, He was called to make choices as well. He wasn't exempt from it, because He had humanity as well. If you remember, Jesus had just been baptized by John the Baptist in the River Jordan. When at that moment of baptism, a dove had descended from the heavens, and a voice of God had announced, "This is my beloved Son. With Him I am well pleased." Jesus and His baptism was not to cleanse Him from sin, because He had committed no sins. Rather, His baptism instead was a sign and it was a symbol for us to mimic, to follow, to imitate of what we needed to do if we intended to become one of His followers. And Jesus' baptism was also a way to begin, and really was the starting point of His own ministry here on earth. So what happened after that? If we look in the Gospel of St. Mark, he records these words about what happened to Jesus before the start of His ministry. St. Mark says it this way: "And the Spirit immediately drove Him out into the wilderness. And He was in the wilderness 40 days, tempted by the devil. And He was with the wild beasts, and the angels were at His side." We are told in the Gospel that even before Jesus started His ministry, He Himself spent 40 days in a wasteland, threatened by wild beasts and tempted by Satan. And that was Satan's plan for breaking down the spirit of Jesus: to shock Him, to tire Him, and eventually weaken Him spiritually, meaning to wear down His faith in God that would help Satan to confuse Christ's mission and goal. I'm sure we all remember the story of Jesus in the wilderness for 40 days. But did we ever think why it was that the Holy Spirit drove Jesus into the wilderness to be tempted? It's no different than what we must go through during our Lenten journey. It was to make Jesus stronger, much like the process of tempering steel makes it stronger. Jesus was called upon to face a challenge and a time of challenge and crisis in order to prepare himself physically, mentally, and spiritually for the ministry that he had ahead. Sound familiar? Great Lent in our church says that we must go through Lent in order to challenge ourselves physically, mentally, and spiritually for the great resurrection. And all the while, just as Satan is above us, Satan was there. He tempted Jesus and offered him a choice. He said, "Surrender to the power of the devil, and I will give you everything, or remain loyal to God and suffer." And Jesus was at his crossroads moment. And it is, my brothers and sisters, the same for us as well. Today's challenges and crises are tomorrow's credentials. Jesus stared down and then faced down the most tempting and seductive lies in Satan's arsenal. And he did it by relying solely on God's word and praise and his promise. And when Jesus emerged from the desert, he did so in victory, in triumph, ready to preach the good news of the coming of God's kingdom. Jesus had shown that he was fully ready for the ministry to which God had called him to do. And by successfully fighting off the devil and temptation and enduring this challenge, Jesus earned his credentials. Jesus endured his trials in the wilderness so that he could provide ever-present help in our temptations. And that is why Great Lent is so important for us. Christ did it to himself, but not for himself. Jesus gave us a lesson, a book to follow. And he did not only preach to us how to do it, he backed it up by his actions. He then actually proceeded to test it out by fasting for 40 days himself, so that we could see that he is not telling us something only in theory. In the Old Testament book of Hebrews, chapter 2, verse 18, we see a passage that directly relates to Jesus when he writes, "Because he himself suffered when he was tempted, he is able to help those who are being tempted." And again in the New Testament, in Hebrews 4, we see the words, "For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but we have one who, like us, has been tempted in every way, just as we are, yet without sin." Now, what does all this mean in plain English? It means Jesus did not preach something for us to follow without having tested it himself. That's why fasting is a requisite during this Lenten season. Jesus himself fasted to prepare himself for his passion and spiritual journey to the cross. And we are called upon likewise to follow that same path to salvation as well. My dear parishioners, we should make no mistake about it. Each day, you and I face hundreds, whether they be small or large, we face hundreds of temptations each and every day. And at the center of every temptation is the same crucial question: Will we choose to follow Christ's example or our own desires? Will we face up to the challenge or will we give in to our weaknesses? Finally, in some of the commentaries on the Gospel of St. Mark, we read that the Apostle Mark had written to a small band of Roman Christians who were under constant persecution in the early church. And they were being persecuted by the Roman government and the surrounding society, who would not accept them in this new found Christian religion. And the Romans invented barbaric practices of sending unarmed Christians into the arena with hungry lions as a form of entertainment. And the Romans would say, if you desire to keep the faith, then it is your decision that you face persecution and death. But if you renounce your faith, you will be allowed to melt back into the anonymous crowd of the Roman citizens and live amongst them. What a choice to make. Hard for some, but probably far too easy for many others. We probably can picture these poor believers gathered in a secret meeting, seeing what lay ahead in their future, and looking with great interest, hungrily reading over St. Mark's letters of encouragement and strength to them, searching for some words of hope that can get them to trudge forward. And they found them in four verses in the first chapter of his gospel. In the first chapter of Mark, verses 12 through 15. The words, at once the Holy Spirit made Jesus go out into the desert, where he stayed 40 days, being tempted by Satan. Wild animals were there also, but angels came and helped him. After St. John had been put in prison, Jesus went to Galilee and preached the good news from God. The right time has come, he said, and the kingdom of God is near. So turn away your sins and believe the good news. There they are, four verses that say it all. These early Christians read where their Savior himself knew what it was like to be alone and hungry, weak, needy, isolated, in danger, surrounded by wild beasts, and tempted to give in, just as they were. And yet, he endured. And because he endured, he sealed our reconciliation with God. Jesus' example gives us courage, it gives us hope and promise that we too can endure temptation and testing as well. My dear brothers and sisters, in our choices lie our destiny. The choices we make will define what type of person we are, what type of Christian we are, and whether our soul is saved or not. Who we are 10 years from now will be decided by the choices that we make today. But no choice is more crucial, no more central, or more influential than our choice to follow Jesus Christ. Because it affects our priorities, it affects our values, our plans, our attitudes, more than any other choice that we will ever make. So, we can ask, will we stand firm in the face of testing? Will we, like Christ, gain the power and assurance that comes from godliness? You and I, throughout our lives, made many, many choices. Some of them beautiful, and others questionable. But the beautiful aspect of the season of Great Lent reminds us that the first message of Jesus' ministry was what? It was to repent, which literally means to change your mind, to change your direction. And that is the challenge that Jesus lays before us today. And it's the church's prayer that we will choose His way for our life. Amen.
Ψυχή μου τον Κύριον ευλογητός, η Κύριε ευλόγη, η ψυχή μου τον Κύριον και πάντα τα εντός μου το όνομα το Άγιον αυτού.
Ευλόγη ψυχή μου τον Κύριον και μη επιλανθάνου πάσας τας ανταποδόσεις αυτού.
Τον ευηλατεύοντα πάσας τας ανομίας σου, τον ιόμενον πάσας τας νόσου σου.
Τον λυτρούμενον εκφράς την ζωήν σου, τον στεφανούντας εν ελέη και εκτιρμή.
Τον επιπλώντα εν αγαθείς την επιθυμίαν σου, ανακαινισθήσετε όσα ετού είναι ότι σου.
Ποιον ελεημός είναι ο Κύριος και κρίμα πάση της αδικουμένη.
Εγνώρισε τα σοδούς αυτού το Μωυσή, της εις Ισραήλ τα θελήματα αυτού.
Ικτήρμον και λεήμον ο Κύριος, μακρόθυμος και πολυέλεος, ουκ εις τέλος οργισθήσετε, ουδέ εις τον αιώνα μηνύ.
Κατά τα σανομία σημών επίσεν ημίν, ουδέ κατά τα σαμαρτία σημών ανταπέδω γεν ημίν.
Ότι κατά το ύψος του ουρανού από της γης εκρατέωσε Κύριος το ελεός αυτού επί τους φοβουμένους αυτών.
Καθώς απέχουσι ανατολέ από δυσμόν, εμακρύνεν αφημόν τας ανώ.